You know, a fresh, new, young commentator comes in, and of course, you're going to do your best to cut his legs off because you want to protect your job.
Trent Barretta now building some momentum.
You know, WWE has a new network coming up, right? We're going to have a lot of opportunities. A
lot of opportunities.
And from what I understand, the buzz is that you're going to be what they call the Chris Berman of the new WWE Network. You're going to be all over the show. You've been here quite a while. I'm sure you can teach a lot of people a lot of things.
I'm sure I could.
Yeah, I look forward to it.
Trying to teach you some stuff right here as Trent Barretta builds some speed right to the jaw of Tyson Kidd, who somehow powers through it, too.
Well, now, this can serve to frustrate Trent Barretta. You know, what's going through Trent's mind now? What do I have to do to beat Tyson Kidd, he seems to say. He also looks like Ashton Kutcher in pain.
You mentioned that Trent Barretta just happy to be here, a superstar that loves every aspect of being in WWE.
Well, what's not to love? This is a lifelong boyhood dream.
Yeah. Barretta. Oh! Got caught there. Right on the mush from Tyson Kidd.
Oh! Dangerous buster right down again on the back of the neck.
Has Tyson Kidd done enough here? How does Trent Barretta kick out at two there?
And again, let's not forget the frustrations. Imagine what's going through your mind if you're Tyson Kidd.
Bang!
I've just nailed my opponent. Take a look again. Watch the way Trent lands. Boom! Right there. But yet still, Trent Barretta keeps kicking out. Tyson is a frustrated, angry man. An angry fighter can be a sloppy fighter.
It's an opportunity, though, for Trent Barretta to still kick out at two. Maybe Barretta didn't have a lot left in the tank, but you got to take your opportunities where you get them, and Trent Barretta doesn't get a whole lot of opportunity.
What is on Tyson's mind? Oh, evidently the ringside barricade. Superstars had till a count of 10 to return to the ring. Trent Barretta doesn't seem to care about that right now.
Happy as can be.
Oh. Got to get him back in the ring, though, Trent.
Or Trent Barretta could just roll into the ring himself and win via countout. Tyson Kidd appears to be out. Barretta perhaps injured as well by that high-risk maneuver.
Take a look once again at the athleticism of Trent Barretta. Let's see the point of
that. And Barretta will opt to take Tyson Kidd back into the ring.
What does Trent Barretta have left in the tank?
What does Barretta have to do to defeat Tyson Kidd? Cover here, outside leg is hooked. This has to go. Tyson Kidd stays alive.
And again, this is a testament to the caliber of athleticism that competes all throughout WWE. What you're witnessing here are two of the finer, younger talents in the WWE locker room trying to set an example for the rookies that will be in the main event tonight. Certainly hope the rookies are watching. What do you think Derek Bateman and Maxine are doing right now?
Probably strategizing, perhaps discussing the one date that Maxine claims to have gone on with Johnny Curtis.
Are you a jealous kind of guy?
Bateman's partner tonight. Oh, no, I don't think so.
Can't wait for the dialogue during that main event.
Ooh.
Oh, what a counter. And now a single leg crab, a submission hold again. The pressure on the back of the neck.
Barretta, that's going to be it. Wow, what a counter.
Here is your winner, Tyson Kidd.
Trent Barretta just kept opting to go for high-risk maneuvers. It finally backfired on Barretta.
Well, that's why it's called a high risk, because if there is no reward, it usually results in defeat. Credit Tyson Kidd for maintaining the strategy. This is the high risk you're talking about, Josh.
Sir, Trent Barretta really had an opportunity to take things over against Tyson Kidd, but just like I mentioned, just one too many times, Trent Barretta
right there
trying for the high risk, high reward. Tyson Kidd hangs around, counters.
Look at the placement
maneuver
of the knee, though. The knee right to the back of the neck that was injured earlier in the match. Congratulations, Tyson Kidd. I certainly hope that there are great things ahead of him.
I wish you had a telestrator out here.
Just had that draw on the screen. Well, either way, I would draw this one up any better than it is right now. Exciting blockbuster tandem of Titus O'Neil and Percy Watson take on the arrogant, condescending team of Johnny Curtis and Derek Bateman. Will the love triangle factor in? We'll find out tonight.
Johnny Curtis, the guy with the milk. I mean, Dirty Curdy. That's what we call him in the back, Dirty Curdy.
Seriously, what is your problem?
What is my problem? Look, I know I have a couple skeletons in my closet, but you went on a date with Johnny Curtis.
A couple skeletons? Snaggletooth? Mm. Patty McFatty?
She's good personality.
Sally with the trick knee? Seriously? Is she a skeleton in your closet? Yeah.
No, she's dead.
Dead? That doesn't sound too satisfying. But, you know, I could think of a couple other things that weren't satisfying, eventful, or meaningful. Of course, NXT being one, and the other being you, Maxine.
We're slapping him now?
What?
We're slapping him because he's telling the truth? Are we slapping him because he's lying? If he's lying, that means he must have been satisfied. And if he's satisfied, I...
All right, good talk. Good talk, guys.
Yeah, I'm saying we need to go back to the States. You gotta get out of Liverpool. This place sucks. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'm gonna take you to a movie. You can wear my chain.
Oh,
you like
man,
that right there?
Yeah,
I
like
see
that.
What I'm thanking.
For real?
What is this?
Oh, you
please
just
tell me.
Come on.
You are not talking to this dude right here.
Since when do I answer to you two?
Yeah.
Stop being like my father.
Yeah.
I can take care of myself.
Man, you know your dad. Wouldn't appreciate you talking to him.
Nah, Santino was better than this fool.
Word, Santino.
First of all, stop right here. Check this out, Playboy. Her father condoned me dating his daughter.
Really?
Because we both got something in common.
What's that?
We both super fly.
You like that? So I did that?
Brother. Plus,
brother.
I got a lot of respect for Tamina. You so, whatever it is.
Uso.
You so ugly. I think y'all gene pool needs a little chlorine.
I mean, why don't you fix it, James?
Chill. No talk.
Ooh.
No talk.
Like that.
We'll handle it in the ring.
Smell. So, 5-4-4.
Hey, I know what that means.
What they say? They gonna stop hating?
Just so you know, I'm gonna be in JTG's corner tonight.
JTG versus Jimmy Uso up next.
You wanna see?
Well, tonight's episode and past episodes of WWE NXT are available on demand on YouTube, Hulu, and of course, our good friends over at WWE.com. Don't miss a single episode of NXT.
Following contest is scheduled for one fall. Already in the ring, accompanied by Jey Uso from San Francisco, California, weighing 251 pounds, Jimmy Uso.
Matt, what is in the water here on NXT? Is Jimmy Uso all set for action? That would be Jimmy on the left of your screen, Jay on the right.
They are twins here, as if you couldn't tell.
His opponent, accompanied by Tamina from Brooklyn, New York, weighing 232 pounds, JTG.
Again, I ask you, what is in the water here on NXT?
I don't know.
It's like a 70s sitcom.
What would you do if you were a father and JTG showed up at your door to take your daughter out? Of course, JTG referencing Tamina's Hall of Fame father, Jimmy Superfly Snuka, and the connection between Tamina and the Usos come from a great stock, of course, legends such as Rikishi, to name a few. So, of course, the entire Samoan lineage is connected. But
okay, but nonetheless, the issue here is the fact that JTG is now sort of dating Tamina.
Well, personally, I find Tamina incredibly attractive, so, Jay may, have some good taste in certain things.
And JTG stating earlier that he's both super and fly.
Well, here's the thing. I mean, have you ever had an ex-girlfriend spill the beans about secrets or maybe intimate details about you? Perhaps Tamina can, smarten JTG up to some of the Usos' tendencies.
Well, if I were dating Tamina, I wouldn't really be discussing the tendencies of the Usos. I'd be doing things with her, going to movies, dinners, things of that nature, baseball games. Jimmy Uso in control here of JTG, the flyest superstar in all of WWE.
Do you know what that means?
Fly? Yeah, it's cool, hip.
Except when you say
along those lines. Take down there by JTG.
Oh, mocking the
Siva Tao.
The Siva Tao, which is the war dance that the Usos do to prepare themselves. It has a a great heritage, so that's an insult.
And you were telling me earlier that you think there's tremendous upside to both Jimmy and Jey Uso.
Oh, yeah, and I like the Usos. I call them young money. They're like the hot new young celebrities, like Logan Lerman or Asher Book or Stephen Strait. These hot new young guys that all the girls are clowning around about. I also like the way the Usos greet their friends. Like, what up, Us? Kind of makes you feel cool.
Yeah,
they greet you that way?
Yes, they do. Actually, Us means brother.
Brother, bro, what's going on? Can I say to you when I see you, what up, Us?
Just turn the other way when you see me. Oh, JTG turned the other way. And Jimmy Uso. A lot of people say that Jimmy's the more powerful of the twin Uso brothers. You have an opinion on that?
Either way, I find both Usos to be extremely proficient inside the ring, whether it be with powerful maneuvers or high-flying ability or just in-ring proficient. You like that soundbite?
And JTG sidesteps Jimmy Uso here.
The WWE superstars are in the midst of a very successful and exciting European tour, and I've just learned that exclusive photo... Oh,
hang on a second here.
Tamina providing somewhat of a distraction there, and JTG taking full advantage. My point was there are exclusive photos on WWE.com, some good action shots, as well as photos of the superstars mingling with the WWE universe.
JTG, into the cover here. Jimmy Uso able to escape. And let me ask you, man, are you surprised at the budding relationship between Tamina and JTG? You seem to be the only person on NXT that's not dating anybody that you know of.
Holler. No, I'm not surprised at all. You know, again, it's all about opportunity, and anytime you can link up with someone just to get more camera time, it works for me. I mean, I'm sitting here with you.
You ready for Survivor Series?
I am very ready for Survivor Series.
New York City, that's home for us.
I'm sorry, what was that?
New York City, that's home for us.
It is.
Madison Square Garden, completely renovated. That's one of the things that Survivor Series you're not going to want to miss.
Oh!
All your friends are going to be talking about it, and you're going to be left out if you miss it.
JTG, another cover here on Jimmy Uso, who powers through it, too.
I'll put you on the spot right now. You want to give me your picks for the three top matches that everyone's talking about? First, I'll start with Alberto Del Rio and CM Punk for the WWE Championship. Who do you like?
Well, all right, if we're going to have this
I'm
debate...
I'm sorry, I asked you an analytical question.
Okay, that's fine. I would rather discuss the comings and goings here of NXT, but you know what? I'll take CM Punk.
Why?
Oh, I don't know, Matt. I didn't expect to be quizzed out here tonight. I was coming here to NXT to have a good time with my old friend Matt Stryker and call some action and have fun, and now you want me to break down the WWE Championship match.
It's either that or we can discuss the disadvantages of JTG's footwear, which you'll roll your eyes at me for,
I have
so
no
I'm
problem
trying.
Discussing that. I actually like the Timberlands that JTG wears.
Why?
Because they're cool, and JTG can use those to his advantage.
You don't need to shout at me.
Oh, look at concern on the face of Tamina as Jimmy Uso looking to take over here. Has Uso done enough to put away JTG?
Well, this is where some of Tamina's advice may help JTG.
How so?
She can, you know, perhaps whisper something, you know, maybe, oh, he's got a bum left knee, or oh, he doesn't like being poked in the eye.
Oh, great counter there.
I mean, who really does?
JTG. But, you know. Another cover, lateral press, Jimmy Uso down. I am just so excited.